99 problems, but a mortgage ain't one.
All right, it is sticker envelope stuffing time, everyone. Lots of orders to get filled, so doing that today. Okay, so who wants Dora? I know a lot of you want Dora. When I almost put it up for sale, or I did put it up for sale a few months ago when I was trying to get that really cool custom cube van I was telling you guys about, I got quite a few offers on this. The highest offer being $32,000 US, which, you know, for summertime, especially RV season, if you guys follow my Facebook page, I put up ads for Class B's all the time that I find all around Canada and USA. There's another guy with an Explorer similar to this, but it was all worn out on the inside. It had all the original ugly faded green carpet, and there were no modifications to it, and he wanted $34,000. Anyways, the point is, I didn't sell it because I didn't get the vehicle that I wanted. The one that I was looking at got sold to somebody else in the meantime, so I said, no, I'm not going to sell this, because I said I'd only sell this if I found something that I really wanted to replace it with. And I've had over 15 RVs over the years. And I think the time for change is coming soon. And I found something again that I'm interested in buying and fixing up and converting. But I'm not going to say, okay, well, I'm not going to sell this if that one sells. I'm going to just put this one up for sale generally. And I'm in no rush to sell it. If someone buys it and I end up getting the one that I have my eye on, great. If not, I'm just going to take my time, even if it means I don't sell it till next month or next year, for that matter. And because, you know, I'm not a used car salesman, but I have had my fair share of vehicles and I've sold them all myself. And I don't deal with tire kickers and people trying to knock down the price on me. When it comes to RVs, they're worth whatever they're worth to the person looking at it. Somebody will look at an RV and go, you know what, this is unique. I'm never going to find another one like this anywhere else, so it's worth it to me. And that's the way I was when I bought this. I really don't give a crap about the price. And the fact I have to pay a few thousand dollars to ship it to Vancouver from St. Louis, irrelevant. I'm doing it. I'm getting the vehicle I want. Because it's not like I can just walk onto any car lot and get one of these. So, the Blue Book values and those sorts of things are pretty much irrelevant when it comes to RV shopping. At least it always has been for me. I buy what I want. Price is pretty much irrelevant. I mean, unless we're talking about hundreds of thousands of dollars, of course. But you guys know all the work I've done to this and all the upgrades I did. It's pretty much unrecognizable from when I bought it. And I'm actually going to set up an email for people interested in purchasing this vehicle. I am not going to deal with people that want to haggle with me. I'm not going to deal with people that want a lower price because they live far away from Vancouver. If you live somewhere outside of Vancouver and you want it shipped to where you live, then you have to take that into account before you make me an offer. So, just to put it simply, I'm in no rush to sell this. I would be happy to keep this for many years to come. But there's a lot of people wanting it. And I know a lot of people want it because I keep hearing from you all the time and I keep getting offers in my damn mailbox, in my messages on YouTube and Facebook. So I'm just going to put a general email out there for you guys if anybody wants to make an offer on this. And I'll entertain all offers. And if I've got something else that I can snap up and move into in the meantime, who knows what'll happen, guys. So, yeah, this is for real. This is not April Fool's, all right? You already know all about it. I don't need to describe it to you. And, you know, it's low miles. It runs like a champ. It's had perfect maintenance, lots of records, tons of receipts. And there's really nothing else I could really do to this. I mean, everything's done. I think I'm looking for a new challenge. I want to start something new and do a new project. And those of you that know me know I've done this over and over and over. I usually kind of finish a vehicle and then I sell it and I start again and do another one. So if you want Dora the Explorer, this is your once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Just email me at iwantdora@gmail.com. I'm going to leave that email open, and we'll see what happens. It doesn't mean I'm going to sell it. By all means, it doesn't mean I'm going to sell it. But you never know. All right, keep on rocking the free world, everyone.